Great, we're live here, Dr. Eliya. And again, thank you everyone who's joining us here on Circle Healing Network and Ask Dr. Eliya and Robyn. Today, once again, we're coming with another episode in the series, What is Love? And we're trying to, in this series, we're talking about love, but we're also talking about personal growth and development. The whole idea of love, not just, what is it, not just, what's the love that's the love of the heart? Eros. But we're talking about all the other, you know, agape and philia and all the formations of love, which is actually a frequency. So today, Dr. Eliya has prepared a slide presentation, which we'll be showing, but we're talking about the love frequency and auras and our interaction with the world around us. You know, how our auric fields interact with everything on the planet and why we have to vibrate at the minimum of the love frequency in order to get anything done, anything that we really want to do that has to do with personal growth, our life path, helping others, et cetera. It really starts with vibrating at least at the love frequency. So we'll talk about that today. And this, as Dr. Eliya was saying earlier, she said this is a plan that we're putting together to help people see exactly how we achieve these things. It's one thing to talk about love, you know, I love you, you love me, and love is what we should be, and love, 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 love. But, you know, what's a practical way of achieving and really working? How do we quantify and qualify love in our life? Because love isn't a verb, it's action. It shows action. And we should have actionable steps that will show us and help guide us to this place of love. So once again, Dr. Eliya, I'm so glad to be here with you and for us to be doing our show like this. You and I have a lot of fun just talking anyway. And we have so many ideas and projects, it's crazy. It's two Taurian women coming together. You know, it's just how we seem to interact. So anyway, thank you. Let's open the show. Thank you, everybody who's come to our network today. We appreciate your support and you're continuing to hang in here with us. And we love all your comments. We love the feedback that you give us. Please continue with that. Please continue suggesting topics. We love that as well. And we'll be getting to all of those questions and topics as we continue to formulate our shows. So anyway, here we go. Let's take it away, Eliya.
Hello, everybody, and I'm so glad to be with you with the next episode of our show. So how Robyn say, we want to explain the steps of the formation of energy state of the bank, because since people don't get the true idea what we want to put inside of all this series, what we made with Robyn. So the point is to explain that the different energy state, they are state to achieve of your level of your consciousness. And when we speak about the chakras and the feelings what each chakra holds in it, this is the vibrational state. So for example, the first chakra have the vibrational state range and the feelings is fear. So, and the organ what represent this chakra is the kidney and bladder, how you know. So when we jump to the fourth chakra, it is again vibrational state and the feeling is love, unconditional love. So all the chakras, they are holders, they are step, they are the transformational step. One by one to achieve a level of consciousness. They represent what consciousness you express at the moment when your all bank work on this level. What mean all your bank work on this level? It means all your each cells of your body to vibrate on that frequency. So it's meaning like the love level have the frequency range, let's say like 500 to 700. And you have all your bank to jump to that platform. And I got a question, if it's possible to build some kind of devices to train ourselves to achieve this level. So you're supposed to become this level. What's me? Each cell to vibrate on this level. It is not your mind to be trained. It is like matrix program or your subconsciousness just to link to some frequency. No, you're supposed to increase the frequency of your brain. And then your bank is able to hold that frequency and to build up, because the frequency of love, the fourth chakra, this is the first step of high vibrational level. The first, the second, and the third, they are low vibrational states. The first one is love. If you want to evolve yourself and to come to the next generation of humans, new kids, how we call them, they are born with on the level of that frequency already. But the humans, what we are born before this time, we're supposed to build up our energy being, our energy level existence. And this is not training of our minds. This mm-hmm. is the build up all the frequency level. And then at least we have to achieve love level. I mean, this range from this frequency. And then we go to the fifth level, sixth level, and seven. So the love, this is not only word, I love you, you love me, and some kind of social interaction. This is the word actually represent the level of existence of all your being. And then when you exist on that level, you act, you behave, you words express the love, you emit the love frequency to others. And actually it's on that level, it is not me to say I love you, because you emit love. You understand? Right. So you already exist on that level, and you don't recognize that you're supposed to admire it, because you exist. When you admire something and when you want to achieve it, or you want to attract it, or you want to take it, but when you exist on that level, you just exist. You don't recognize that you are in it. Everything for you is love. The food is love, your shoes is love, the interaction with people is love, interaction with stones is love, everything. Right. So that is the true meaning, what we want to show you, that all these lectures, if it is not lecture, talks between two Taurian, is to show that is the what is the real real goal of our show. Just to keep you in the normal human language, to explain you, that is the purpose of our evolution. How in normal way with the simple, how to say, it is not trick, but point to point you how you're able to achieve evolution of your level, and it starts of your understanding. And have so famous sentence, I don't want to believe, I just want to know. Because when you know, it's changing your belief system. When change your belief system, what's mean? The filter of knowledge, what you accept and then you represent, is more wide. You know,
right.
When you believe you are blind, you just take it something without understanding. And without understanding, you're not able to create from you anything more. You just accept and hold. But right. When you understand and when you know, then you create and build up. On that way, new kids came, you know, just they build up on us in Indigo and the generation between them.
And to your, Exactly. And to your point, as you were talking about how kids, we are born in through the love frequency vibration. That's how we even, I mean, life is created at least at that point of vibration. And so we come in on that vibrational level. And, you know, which is one of the things that over time I discovered is the detriment of cartoons. You know, they seem like, oh, so innocent. Oh, you know, but they're full of things that start training children to be fearful, to bring all the vibrations down. You see a little doggy get shot and then get up, ha, 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 you know, and they make it a big funny thing. But it's shocking to the system, and it starts bringing the vibrations down, seeing all the little shooting and killing, all the little innocent, and even clowns. Most babies are afraid of clowns, you know, but they make it seem like, oh, clowns are so fun, hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. But it's an original way to create fear and start lowering that vibration, and that's how we get to where we are right now. So I wanted to just to throw that in to your point.
Yeah, and before in the previous show, we say that in a way, when we start to educate our kids how the matrix work, we separate them from true stuff and teach them from the artificial stuff what matrix asks us to do.
Exactly.
Yeah, they are not natural for humans. I mean, original, you know, they're not natural. Everything what is natural, kids come with it.
Yes.
And then we start to teach them to not do this, to not do that, and this wrong, this right, you know?
Yes.
Just modulate them. It's regarding in which one society they born.
Yes, exactly.
And we start to modulate them consciousness, belief system, and everything, and make them robots. So now the point is, because, I mean, new kids already born, and no one can deny and no one can hide them, because there starts to be a huge amount of them. So point is to show the generation between before the new kids that it's possible when you want to change yourself, inner you, to achieve the same level of consciousness. At least, again, I say love range, I mean frequency range of the fourth chakra, and then to build up to fifth, to sixth, to seventh, and so on. So right. this is the inner self work. It's no one will give you, and no one can train you. This is the work from you, and you're supposed to do by yourself, consciously, to know what you do. So that is the purpose of all our explanations, what we do with Robyn, just to show that the normal, ordinary people, they are able to achieve. It's no need to be genius. It's no need to be a spiritual guru or to meditate 24 hours. It's not working on that
exactly.
way. So this is like, you know, consciously to change your knowledge and to change your belief system, and actually to live in that way, because natural laws, they are building blocks of everything on that planet. They are built stones, they built us, they built machine. Everything works in natural way, I mean. Mm-hmm. And if you know them, so you're able to change yourself and to choose how you want to fulfill your mission, how you every day choose your clothes on the same way. So your purpose is to reach that point, but have so many ways to this point. So if you know in advance all this way, you just choose, oh, I feel happy today to go on that way. Oh, today I will just cross a little bit and see Robyn, and then I go to fulfill my mission. You know, it's like, but you're aware what you do and consciously choose, you know, how
right, exactly.
to reach this point. So not blindly just someone put you, you know, just close your eyes and to push you, go there. Why?
And also, and also, not like society has taught us, is that love is something that happens to us. That's why we spend so many wasted years looking and searching for love in other people. Love isn't something that happens to us. Love is something that we generate. And through the generating of it, by output, we will attract the similar vibration and create loving relationships that are all vibrating at the same level. And this is also to the point of what we want to talk about and share in these episodes in the show, is the idea that it's almost breaking the old paradigms about how we were taught love operates, and really look at, in truth, how love operates so that we can fulfill so many of the things we want to fulfill.
Yeah, because it's they turn everything upside, and when you get the habit to work in some level, you just believe, so that's it. So I just wake up, I go to work, I earn some money, and after work, I go to the market. I spend all this money what I earned today. So what is the purpose to work today? I don't know.
Then you go to the bar and you get drunk.
Because I'm upset that, you know, I earn and I lost my time. I don't have time for myself, for my kids, for my beloved, for anyone, just because I have to earn some amount of money and to spend it in the market or whatever. I mean, I don't hold them, you know, like this. I just have to spend because I have to give to the next one what serve to the society. So
exactly.
It's been all the time we exchange some kind of amount of money, we exchange and spend our time for no one knows for what. And finally, we got some years, we give and we go in patient, and then we die, and so that's it. You know, it is like one common scenario for all the nation, all the societies and everything. And people, you know, someday they just start to think, okay, but what is the meaning of this? I mean, it's no one find the meaning because the meaning is twisted. It's not right. The meaning of our existence. This is artificial meaning what they put because it's easy to manage the society, to produce and to serve for some others, what they know the purpose, but they make us to don't know. So actually, I'm going to say, these guys are so smart and I appreciate them, that they know everything and they know how to use. It's knowledge, probably.
Right.
But you know, sometimes the stupid become smart too, so they start to learn from smarter. And we just want to try to explain this, that actually everyone is able to achieve this level. It is nothing supernatural. You're not become superheroes. No, you have in you. You just have to remember how to use it and the true meaning of all
right.
This kind of stuff.
And so certainly the whole point of, you know, everyone talking about, you know, the awakening, we've awakened, the whole idea of so many of these movements, regardless of how you want to frame yourself, is that it's like, you know, you think about animals in a zoo, Eliya, where, you know, the zookeepers and the trainers take the little baby lion, who's designed to be bold and, you know, be out in the, you know, in his community protecting. They take the little baby because they want him to stay in this little cage and raise him up for the people to come and see him. So you start training him against his nature. So he becomes what it is you need him to be in your world, which we'll call the zoo. And so that's pretty much what we've dealt with on this planet. You know, we've been taken from a little baby and we've been reshaped to be what was needed, the worker bee, you know, the policeman, the librarian, the thing. And you grow up, you pick the thing you want to do. Okay, you want to do that. Okay, so we'll show you how to be that, and that's it. Boom. And so we've come here to this point in time to have to now go back and sort of relearn the natural ways in which we should be, like the lion, if we're set wild, would have to go back and relearn so many things just to be a lion, you know, in nature. And I think that's a comparison as to what we're experiencing now.
Yeah, and also, and you know that the birds, when they're born in cage, even you open the door, they don't fly out of the cage because they don't know that something exists out of the cage.
Right.
And
exactly.
I have this experience with my bird. I just opened the door and just waiting. You know how many days still this bird get idea that the door is open and to let and then several days just watching, you know, outside of the door. What is it? You know, accept reality that it's something more big out of the door. Can you imagine? I just sitting and watching this bird day by day, because we are the same. Our consciousness is the same, because how we said on the previous videos, if you have the view from your first chakra is like this, second, third, fourth, it gets wider and wider and wider, and then you're able to get more perspective from your sense and more understanding, and you see the stuff of the the life. Now, like you working on the first, second, third, you work in clothes. Even sometimes you get the spark of ideas, but you just guess, could be this, could be this, could be this, but you're not sure, because you can see, and even you cannot imagine that exists. It's out of you, I mean, out of your range of understanding. The same with birth. We are absolutely the same, like a bird, you know. So like that. And if you want, we are able to represent the PowerPoint and with pictures, and people then will get one by one, I mean, idea smoothly what we want to say about the aura and how two auras interact with each other, because stone have an aura, tree have an aura, everything have an electromagnetic field around, and we interact with electromagnetic field at first with some bank, material or not material.
And I'm opening it now.
Yeah.
Okay. Here we are. Can you see it?
No, you just close it at that moment.
I'm sorry.
Been, and now it's disappeared.
Do you see it now?
No.
Okay. Let me just do it again. Okay.
Yeah. So with PowerPoint, it's more easy, more visible for people to follow the logic, because when you use eyes, like analyzator of information, is come more easy to the brain directly. So now it's visible.
Okay, so I'll click it and you can see it. How's that?
Yeah, but you're able to click on the slideshow.
That's what I'm going to go back in.
It's more.
Just so it's the whole thing playing.
Yeah, but they disappear when you put play. So just use one by one, then just make it a little larger.
When it plays, it does. Is it back? Oh, let me just let me start it again then. Yeah, it should. You would think with it being on play, it should stay. But we'll just do it one by one then.
Yeah, just make it the picture more wide and people to be able to see them, because now it's visible on your screen, all the triggers.
I'll try doing a desktop and maybe I can control it better. Oh. Okay, guys, we're going to get it.
You will get it. This is not problem. And now, actually, you see the perspective of your aura. You know, this picture inside of picture inside of picture.
I know. You see that? I know.
This is exactly the picture of your aura, because all the energy bodies, what they call in spirituality, they have a frequency range. So even in the Tibetan book of death, if you have it, you may read the stages, what the energetic field get after the physical death. But actually, physical death is the end of all decompression of other fields. So when we appear in the electromagnetic spectrum of our planet, and on the electromagnetic spectrum of the human shape. So how we spoke before that, we appear like a microwave, high vibrational state being. And then we go with low speed to the human shape. What's mean, this is the compression of electromagnetic spectrum, and you go to the lower level, to the lower level, to the lower level. And actually, we landed in one bubble, like this, what you see in the moment. So we landed inside of the womb of our mothers, and we start to grow and take a shape like our humans. But before that, you know, all the energy bodies, what we call with different frequency, they exchange information first between them, and then that information that get compressed is like the print when we want to resend some file, and you put in the flash drive. Mm-hmm. On the same way, you just compress all the fields, and finally appears material body, solid matter.
Uh-huh.
So, okay, and then the next slide.
Okay. Did I get rid of it, or is it still there?
No, you just have to use only choosing the slides, you know, the plate. Just one by one, have to choose.
I'll just have to keep that window open then. I was trying to make it full by closing that side, but I'll leave it open. Right here.
Yeah. So when we appear like solid matter, for our eyes, like a material analyzer of our brain, we're able to see our solid matter. But actually, how you see on that slide, we appear like a light beings. And we exist like a light being, just we are able to see our material body. But all others' frequency around us, what we call bodies, like etheric, emotional, mind, causal, Buddha, galactic, and so on, they exist around our material body, and they belong to our being. So actually our aura is more or less 8 meters. So we exist 8 meters. We're not, our existence is not finished on the border of our skin. It's finished after these 8 meters, the range of our aura. And actually aura is the shape of egg. Exactly how you see on the left picture. And on the right picture, this is the embryo after abortion. It's the human after abortion inside of our amniotic sac. So it is a representation in matter level, how you look like inside of your aura. This is matter, and you're inside of one egg shape. This is the same, because everything in nature follows the law as above, as below. So do you understand what I mean?
Let me just ask you a quick question. So you were talking about in terms of the our auric field, were you saying that it was 8 meters?
8 meters, you meters. Exist.
Okay,
yes,
I just wanted to make sure that was clear.
Yeah, okay. The shape of egg. Exactly how it is on the left picture.
And which is why if we really were taught that early on, and we really embraced the fact that our own auric field was 8 meters in, you know, in this spherical shape or this egg shape, you would realize how many people you're constantly intersecting with.
Yes,
you
know, all the time.
We're one, you know?
Yes, you're never alone. And also when your life in apartment or in building, you all the time interact with electromagnetic field of cables, Wi-Fi, TV, all the devices, you know?
Right.
Actually, your electromagnetic spectrum, it's just never alone. It's all the time interaction with something other, electromagnetic fields with different origin.
Right.
Understand?
Right. Yep.
So and on the left picture, you see how all the chakras emit the frequency, because the chakras, they are like double torus with the direction back front. So it is the state where when you get the frequency range from if say seven chakra is high vibrational, they slow down to six, slow down to five, slow down to four, slow down to third, to second, to first. And this is slow downing and store the specific frequency of each chakra. It's because each chakra energizes the specific area and organs. So these organs, they work in that frequency. You cannot put them in high vibrational source because they will burn out. So even that is explanation that if you want to work in a high frequency level, all your banks supposed to be in advance prepared. To understand,
yes.
Because the cells, the organs, they will burn out, they will be not able to hold and work. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
So the next slide then.
Okay. This time I'll hit this and go back to navigator.
Yeah, so the next slide you will see how it looks like exactly the aura. See how the chakras emission just react with aura. So all your chakras, they connected with all the layers of your aura. And all on the right side, you see all the layers. This is layering. And from spiritual work, most of you know the names of layers, what is the distance of each layer from a material body, what is the distance between each a layer to the next one. And I want to tell you that the seven chakras, main what you know, they are on the flow of Kundalini, Sushumna channel. But in emotional body, mind body, casual Buddha, Bodhisattva body, they have the chakras too. And again, I say the chakra, this is the storage bank of specific frequency. And this is the storage bank become a source to feed the specific area of you existence. I mean, in different bodies. So the seven chakras, what we know, this is in Kundalini. But you have so many other storage bank in different layers of your aura. So you are one factory of free energy, if you are aware of it, because you work on the level of free energy. You take from space free energy, from ether, or some called zero point universe, or how you want to call it, and then you transform to be able your body like device to work on that level, and then you emit the same way the free energy, you know. You just take it and give it back, take it and give it and you give back. This is the perpetual mobile, what we actually make between our devices, body and universe,
right?
Yes. So next slide then.
That's a really such good illustration to be able to see, you know, exactly the idea of free energy. I remember when you were saying that before when we were talking, how huge that the idea, you know, the idea of free energy, it exists outside of us. We're taught that it exists outside of us, like we have to wait for somebody to discover it and then do it and then we buy it or show us how to do it. But in fact, what you're saying and what is the truth of the universe is that we are free energy producing machines, and we are the original free energy producing machine. We operate in a universe in which is this exchange, you know, this constant exchange, and that it's about switching our paradigm, our constructs about how we think about energy to put us more in an appropriate place to be able to operate out of free energy.
Yes, and also when you start to work, how we say, at least in the level of fourth chakra, look, at least on that range, then the window is open and you're able to see that free energy, you know?
Right.
And to be aware that this free energy is not illusion, This is real stuff. And you are able to operate and how to produce and use for humankind and to make devices or whatever to serve you.
And I think also, you know, one of the things for me and any of our listeners who work with energy at all, and I'm sure this was the same with you, when I first became a Reiki master, which was about 30 years ago now, that was really my first contact with how energy is working. And you, because you become a conduit through which that energy is flowing all the time. You really become unaware of the flow of it until other people come into your space or come around you, or you work on as a healing modality with the Reiki, and then you realize that, or other people sense this energy and it's doing things. You don't even know oftentimes what that energy is doing yourself. You just are this conduit through which the universe, it's flowing. And many energy practitioners or various, types of energy work, it's operating like this. And so the idea that you're doing anything where the ego would be involved in this is really false. The energy is working through you, and oftentimes you don't even know what the purpose of it is, because it's connected with consciousness.
Yeah, you become a channel of already existence free energy in ether. Even your body is built on a way of antenna. You receive and then you resent.
Yes.
That is the, you attract, and you, and because of that, in spirituality, they say you descend and then you ascend. It means you take and then you give.
Yes.
Understand? Mm-hmm. So when you descend, it means you take energy, you compress the field, you organize them, you create something from them, and then you ascend. You just open and then go. You give to universe, you give to flowers, you give to stones, you give to people, to animals. You know, this is the ascension. When you open up, I mean, you open your fields already transformative, organized from you.
Yes.
You understand?
Yep.
And actually, when you're all the layers of your electromagnetic spectrum, 8 meters, what you exist on this planet, they have a double Toro shape. And because we take energy from the source and from the planet, we organize in double Toros. And we get finally the shape what you see in the moment. And it is well known like a tree of life, like a flower of life, seed of life. It is depend which part of the torus you look like. And this is like a double donuts when they spin around each other. And if you remember when you make a shape of the torus, and one part is the torus of the heart, what is the 5,000 times more stronger than the torus of the mind. And I will tell you why. Because when two toruses is like an energy meet together, actually the middle point of them interaction in embryo, we speak on them interaction, is where the heart plays. That's why after time of the embryo development, suddenly heart starts to beat. This is only one thing in your body what have the movement itself, dynamic, like a pump. Because exactly on that place we have interaction of these two forces, what our body transcend and transmit and allow to pass through. That's why body... that's why heart actually move and have a pumping function and have a current electromagnetic vector itself of his work.
Right.
And like a torus itself and working like an engine. You understand? So that's why this is the 5,000 times more stronger than the brain, because brain is receiver, transmitter, receive and transmit. You understand?
Right.
And hold information. It is not pumping it all around. the body. So the heart is more dynamic structure than the brain. You know, brain is organizer. I mean, brain like a computer of your head, you know. So it is organized all the situations, all the functions, all the things what you're supposed to do, like device. And not only when we speak about the consciousness. Consciousness is not a representation of your brain. Consciousness is above. Brain is brain. This is the processor computer inside of your head, what manage all device, what we call body. That's his brain. Consciousness is consciousness. It is something different. So then you get this kind of a double torus around your body, what actually you represent. That is you. You exist 8 meter, and you interact with other beings on this planet with all electromagnetic bubble what you have around you. So the next slide.
Okay, sounds good.
Yeah, so actually interaction between people starts 8 meters before, you know. This is not just when you're crossing your hand and say nice to meet you. It's nice to meet you 8 meters before.
Exactly. I was noticing this slide right here came from some of the work of Meg Benedicte, and I've worked with her. I've been in some of her groups, and I'll tell you, she's a very powerful magnetic presence, really a dynamic individual. For those of you who want to just check out her work, it's Meg Benedicte. She's out at Mount Shasta. We'll have to ask her on the show sometime. She's got a lot of really good energy. I like her work.
Yeah, she's really good.
Yeah, she is. Let me move to
the next one. The next one is this more schematic view, just to see how.
I'm busy pressing on the wrong one. I'm like confusing myself. I'm pressing on the one on the screen.
Yes, fifth one. Yeah.
Okay.
So this is more schematic view. How actually you get two double toruses, and then interaction between these two double toruses give you all the aura, like a sum of two toruses, like sum sumarian to rotary. So and how you see actually the assembling point, the line of interaction, this is the zone of your heart. That's why you have your heart on this place, and this is not in your foot. So for example, so many times, you know, kid asked me why the heart is there and this is not in your hand or in your head or in our foot, you know. This is because of that, because of interaction of these two vortexes, and in the zone of interaction, in the electric point, what here is called assembly point, you get this interaction. And then you got the shape of egg. So now the next slide. Everything is mathematics and physics, natural one. When you get it and when you understand it precisely, you are able to manage your body, your life, everything around you. So actually that is the shape of how the toruses come. I mean, energy from space, from earth, interact in your body. And you get a donut shape, you see? And everything is spinning. This is not static formation. This is dynamic formation around you. All the time, all the energy, all electromagnetic field around you, this is in dynamic construction, make a shape. Regarding of your level of consciousness, regarding of your interaction with other electromagnetic fields around you. So all this spinning and taking the shape directly influence your consciousness, directly manage you. So if someone wants to interact with your consciousness, manage your consciousness, it's able to manage the electromagnetic fields around you. And to change the shape of this electromagnetic field, and then directly, no need even to talk to you and to look at you, you know, change your belief system and your perception of reality directly. Okay, so now the next slide. This is more physical view, but I try to say in the simple way, just people to get idea that they are holder of device. Body is device and emit electromagnetic spectral field. So now you
can. Now, I mean, I think this is really good. Like they say, a picture's worth a thousand words, and this is a lot of good, you know, ways for people to just see how these fields are working and intersecting, along with an explanation. Because sometimes you see these pictures, but you don't get the full total explanation like that you're giving right now. So.
So you see, for example, here, this is again double board. Only in our planet works like duality, double vortices, then four. You know, every time you have to have male, female, minus, plus, duality, because that duality gives you direction of flow, spinning. This free energy, where to organize, how to organize, in which way to spin, give a direction. Because in ether, in gravity, everything is chaotic, just exists, you know, house. Mm-hmm. It is not direction of the flow. To give a direction of the flow, you have to make a magnetic force, you know, just to give the direction where this force supposed to go, how the free energy to organize. Because free energy is something what even you cannot imagine how much big it is. So you, with your organization of the flow, you took part of it, how much you are able to use, transform, to hold. You understand? You don't take all, it's everything, you know, free energy is everything. You just took part of it and use. So your body do the same with these two vortexes, show how to organize electromagnetic spectrum of this device, what we call human body, and then how form these toruses, and see how the spinning goes on the same way Kundalini goes, Sushumna channel goes, all the spinning of the earth goes, and able in everything what is in this planet, your DNA turn on that way. This is because of that. You understand? Yes, so now the next slide, this is more easy. How works your DNA? What is the shape of DNA? This is the same of shape of your electromagnetic spectrum. That's why when someone see the DNA in electro microscopy or Raman or whatever, this is the material view of your DNA. DNA, this is the light structure. That's why you have 12 strands of DNA, but this is the 12 light strand. It's possible to be material to see after years, but at the moment, if you see only two, and you feel your consciousness belongs not only to two, but little more, just because they are still in high vibrational level, and your brain with these eyes cannot see. But it's not mean that they don't exist. Just you cannot detect them, because eyes, like material detectors, still they have a range of operation.
Right.
You understand? So other strands of DNA, they exist, but they are high vibrational. So here you're able to see how just torus form, and if you make it from some kind of wires, and even have this kind of kit toy, you know, when they put these wires and make different kind of shape, you know, you just splash and they open and they close, they open, they close. So actually aura make the same things. When you interact with electromagnetic field from other person or device or something else, what is more strong than you, don't match to you, your aura just change the shape, get other shape, adapting to other electromagnetic field. Understand? Sometimes this is so harmful for the all the levels of electromagnetic spectrum where you exist, harmful to the matter level. That much harmful is this, because the harm comes from all the layers of aura, and the matter body is inside, is protected like in egg. So to reach you like a solid matter, interaction come from so far away. And if the all the layers of aura can stop this interaction and reach you like on your skin, it means this is harmful electromagnetic field, but open all the layers of your aura. It is like to broke egg and go inside.
Right, exactly. I think also, when you were talking about the 12 strands or the light strands, and you know, you can't necessarily see all these with your eyes, or whether your eyes are not the tool in which all of them are to be seen, is that, you know, that goes back to the whole idea about the vibration, at least starting at your fourth chakra and vibrating from love. Because I know for me, a lot of times I'm sensing a lot of my other magnetic field from other parts of my senses. You know, it's like your other senses connect into these vibrational fields. And I think also in health and healing is why so many things that are coming to harm us on those energetic, on the EMF fields, the EMT fields, because they go in and start breaking down these this light structure, which allows the disease to get in and penetrate us to the physical level.
Yes, absolutely. And actually, this is the interaction between the auras. If you get the disease from viruses, for example, you get, because your aura interact with aura of virus, it means your electromagnetic spectrum interact with electromagnetic spectrum field of virus. They match, they interact. Mm-hmm. And then during this interaction, you get the physical symptoms.
Yes. And I think that's, and that goes back to the old, where many of the old mystics and gurus talk about controlling the mind. You control all things related to the body. And, you know, when you are controlling and you're thinking health and you're holding your structure together through consciousness, it matches the vibration. And so viruses can be all around you. But like you said, they are not going to be able to penetrate because you're not vibrating at the level of that virus, even from the consciousness, you know, from a point of consciousness. And so you just don't attract it.
Yes. When you're far away, vibrational state from something, I mean, you have two subjects, one high vibrational, one low vibrational. This low vibrational cannot see high vibrational.
Right.
You understand? So how much your high vibrational bank, so less things can affect you, what is normal now from our matrix society.
Yes, exactly.
So that is the point. And also the point is to know from what you are built. When you know your structure, you're able to so quick and early diagnose yourself. When you sit on one chair and you feel uncomfortable, I mean, not because chair is not comfortable, just you feel uncomfortable. It means that you sense electromagnetic spectrum for something what interact and disturb yours. So just stand up and go away.
Yes, that makes sense.
Instead of, you know, just keep yourself and say, no, I supposed to say, stay, I don't understand what's wrong, it's here.
Right. Understand? Yes.
So, or when you get interaction with some person and you feel uneasiness, you know, it's not just open to this person, you feel uneasy to this, something disturbing you, you know? Electromagnetic spectrum interaction cannot lie. For him, it's not value belief system. For him, it's not value social laws.
And to your point,
good, you know?
Yeah, and to your point, that's why it's so important. You know, we are oftentimes taught in this society, you know, that not to trust your initial instincts about people. But I have learned every time I've gone against my initial instinct about a person, it's come back to bite me in some kind of fashion, because those energetic fields are meshing at that point. When you first meet a person, you're picking up their vibrational field. And if it's a match, you move forward. If it's not a match, you're to separate. And this is where so many times relationships go bad, because you don't adhere to that first time you meet somebody. You say, oh, he's nice enough, she's nice enough, but little different. And then you stay around them. Either you're going to school with them or you go to work with them or whatever. You get to sort of, you start getting used to that vibrational feel, and then they start feeling familiar to you. It's because that you're allowing your energetic field to mesh. And of course it's going to start feeling familiar because we adapt. So it kind of goes back to that original thing about how we, when we first, you know, come in contact with people.
Yes, this is all the time like this. Even the situations have electro vibrational state. So if you arise your vibrational state, you attract more vibrational, high vibrational state situations around you. Right. They are living back the situations. They are living beings. They are not like you in shape, but they are beings. You know, the energy beings.
Yes.
So they interact with you. You understand?
Yeah.
So next one slide.
Alrighty.
No, just I want to try to people to understand them. You know their structure. And no, then it's easy for them to think. You understand? This is not that complicated stuff when you get, I mean, really simple part. So this is the shape of Taurus. This is exactly like vortex you get in water in your tub or in some river or in sea. This is the, or like tornado. This is vortex shape, what is spinning. And in the 3D model, this is more graphic. Even you see how make when during the spinning make ages, you know, show the direction where exactly goes.
Right.
So exactly how the spinning goes and make the ages. This is the entrance and exit of each chakra. If we speak about the Kundalini. So if this is the central channel of this void. This is the central channel of the void of your being. And then when the spinning just cross, it's make opening the enter of chakra. So part of this energy goes out of the center of chakra, back and front. Do you understand? And starts to energize this level of your body.
Yes.
That smartly nature made everything. To not lose, this is without any waste of energy, any, you know?
Right.
That's perfect, is it? So and that's why I ever say we are a perfect base, the best one creature in this universe, like devices. So then the next slide.
Okay.
Actually, you are one void, and you interact like void with everything.
Right.
That is so important to know. That's why people say that you interact with Wi-Fi, even you don't see it. You interact with your microwave, with your phone, with everything.
Right. Makes sense.
So, yes. So now when the vortex just spin, if you just cut one level of the vortex, you get the Morbius shape. So all the vortex goes like eight, you know, infinity. Mm-hmm. All the levels of the Taurus, they even represent that we are perpetuum mobile. It's infinity. Never ending energy. Go in and go out and repeat itself. That's why eight represent infinity. And around each cycle of the Taurus, around each curve of this eight, you build your plasma energetic level, what is built up and make your aura layers by layers. If you analyze the structure from core, if you take core like our body, material body, and then you just unfold to all the layers of your aura. And finally, the shape of infinity in Taurus, how you see on the picture below, is the representation of yin yang in Tao symbol. Mm-hmm. So ancient people want to show us what we are really are, you know, that we are never ending free energy devices. Understand?
And so you're talking about even, it's interesting, and I think this is what you were just saying, that the first picture on the bottom is like the Tao symbol, the yin and yang. You know,
yes,
you
that's it.
Yin and yang right there. It's amazing. Yes. Just the, how,
yes.
how,
yes.
And you know, it's in ancients, we're able, which goes back to show, you know, we're talking about we're evolving, but in a lot of times I think we've devolved because we've become further away from so much of this knowledge, and so much of our senses have sort of been dumbed down in a way, because, you know, all these symbols and stuff happened before, you know, we had so-called modern science with, you know, with technology that could see energy and blah, 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 blah. I mean, you know, these things existed prior to all of that. So we claim to be more evolved, but oftentimes I feel it's a devolution of sorts, you know?
Yeah, we are more evolved of the toys.
Yeah.
The technical stuff, but we can not more evolved in the conscious level.
Yeah, right.
I ever said that the toy technology is the opposite of consciousness evolution. I mean, how much toys you have, that much conscious just slow down. I mean,
slow down.
Because you use it like sticks. This is not to use it for evolution at all.
And so, also, when it hit me here, we were talking, you know, it being from the artist in me, you know, I'm looking at all these graphs and stuff, and I'm thinking, you know, our sign that we selected for to represent our show and the work that we're doing with the various projects we have has been the combination of the analemma, which is the path mm-hmm. of the sun traveling in the year, which is an infinity. It's a figure eight. And also we chose that analemma and the infinity, along with the Taurus, the sign of Tutarians. But when you were showing the picture of the vortexes spinning, it was interesting that that whole analemma with the Tauruses were present there, you know? And it's just amazing how it does go back to all these energies, astrology and everything. All the symbols can be found in these analemmas and in these vortexes. They just all exist there.
Yeah, it exists because Tauruses, regarding the astrology, this is the first sign who realize ideas. So the Aries generate ideas, and the Tauruses realize them, make them real. So that's why they're supposed to be in infinity, no?
Exactly.
Never ending realization.
Never ending. Yeah, we're in infinity.
Yes. So it is the same. We may say like yin yang in the symbol of Tao, like for one person. But it is the same aspect like male and female. That's why we are separate in the two polarity bodies, because together we make the common field and the production of the free energy. And how I told you before, even now they catch how the producing the light when the spermatozoid go inside of ovule cell is a spark of light. You understand?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So actually when two different polarities meet each other, they make interaction in the area of interaction, the electricity. This is the point where starts to open the free energy source. So actually that is the meaning, one thing to split to two, to give a direction of Tauruses, because the Taurus direction energy flow in women is its opposite than in men. And when we combine different directional vortexes, you understand?
Yes.
So they interact, they make a line of interaction, the electricity, and we are in free energy area.
Yes. Yeah.
So from that free energy comes new banks, new works, new ideas, jump consciousness. That's why we are just split to two, to give a direction of this free energy source where to go.
Right, right, right.
Understand?
That makes sense. Uh-huh.
Yeah. So actually that's why I said that they make the art of coupling, what we call sex or chip, because this is the huge meaning. If people know how they produce itself free energy and how they're able to produce free energy by coupling, they be, I mean, surprised, and they will put different meaning in the art of sex, completely different.
Right, it makes sense.
You understand? So yeah. Next one.
Yes, I'd be glad to. Alrighty.
Yeah, so other one is just a representation of ever asking shape of your Merkaba. So you make your shape because of these two toruses, what you form and interaction of vortexes, you get the shape of Dodecahedron. But this is the graphic view of double toruses. If you want to make the graphic view of double toruses, you get shape of Dodecahedron, what we call shape of Merkaba. So that shape you have around you, actually that is the graphic explanation and the graphic view of our aura.
So right, and here, I'll just point it out. Here are your two auras coming together there, mm-hmm. which create, are coming together into the one toroidal field, creating at the point of each of the tops of those in the inner side.
Yeah, this is the common one. This is the third torus. So you have one torus here itself is working like this.
Yeah.
And another one is working like this. This is sustainable. Right. Then interaction, because of this free energy, what they reach out between them interaction, they make one common.
One larger one, which creates
the one that contain both of them,
which then makes the Merkaba. And then this all feeds into the flower of life, which people know. And you know, for those of you who have studied the flower of life, and that flower of life is everywhere, you know, in all the cultures, you find it in the sacred places. Here again, at times, like as you say, Dr. Eliya, there were not any toys that would have broadcast it that this existed, but some kind of way, you know, they knew this. So, you know, this is important for
us. It's important. And also in some other episodes, I will show you the representation of human body, how all the organs, their place or specific place, but how they connect to each other. And actually all them places make a tree of life. So all organization of eternal organs, they are on the place of tree of life, exactly.
Yes, yes, we'll have to do that. Probably should actually do that after this one so that it makes a consistency. And I was thinking with the work that I've been doing with more of the tantric art, probably should do that towards the end of this series, because then all of that will really make sense against these PowerPoints.
Yeah. So first, first, let's represent the building blocks and people to get image what they really are, and then how they may use this kind of thing.
How we use it, exactly. Perfect. Yeah.
So then the next one.
Okay.
So the next one will give you just representation how looks like. So see how looks like fear. And how narrow and small torus you have, like an aura around you. And what is this is the level of your first chakra existence, first, second, what mostly our society now exists. And when you jump to the low level, the frequency range of the low level, how wide become your aura. So your aura, this is your sense, what we call sixth sense. You sense with it, and you make your perspective more wide because you start to sense more wide spectrum of electromagnetical spectrum of others, of inside of the free energy you make for yourself for more big space to exist.
Yeah.
And that means that your surface starts to be more big and more wide, and then you get more interactions. Not interactions like one nuts, but the interactions like one block. You understand?
Yeah. Let's talk about the three hearts. Point that out again. I know we brought that up in other shows, but let's, while we're looking at it here, talk about the location of the heart, the three hearts.
Yeah, the three hearts, and how I thought this is the point where two Tauruses just connect, how it's in earth. This is the core for us, core. This is the heart, and the heart from the galaxy. This is the sun of galaxy. So our heart, this is the sun, and the core of the planet, this is the sun, the representation of the sun, of a generator. What is generating, you know, life, if a dynamic future is in it, how the core of our planet is the magnet. This is double magnet, this is the generating of dynamics. So everything, what is, you know, when you have a specific shape, all the time two specific shapes, they recognize each other more easy, and they connect each other more easy. That's why our heart, we connected with the heart with planet and heart with the galaxy, because have a same shape, like electromagnetic shape, you understand?
Right.
And because of that, they make this kind of analogy with Tauruses, because we are Taurus. We're not representation with only two legs, 2 foot, and head, and so on. You know, we are just Taurus represent. Taurus planet is a Taurus, is not just a globe, and galaxy on the same way. So we, our heart is on the center of this Taurus. The core of the planet is the center of the Taurus, and the sun of the galaxy in the same way. So all the centers, they're connected, and ever information keep the shortcuts, you know, to the center. It's not going around, and then to reach a point. Ever water and information trying to find the shortcut. So what is the shortcut? Center to center.
Right, exactly. That's the shortest. And so when you look at this first one too, it occurs to me, this is a very good representation of what people have always are hearing about the frequency of fear, and why the powers that be you call the shadow government, the cabal, whatever the, you know, we consider the negative sort of controlling force, is always creating fear, you know, in terms of movies, in terms of all of our lifestyle, you know, because if it can keep you at fear, you see how much further reduced your whole auric field is. So you're a lot easier to overtake and overpower by all the other electromagnetic stuff that's coming your way. You're not as strong as if you stay in love, because you can combat this stuff so much more easily. And this is just an excellent representation of that concept that people have heard time and time again.
Yeah, and also when you stay on the level of fear, it's not only your perspective is so close, you cannot see the solutions so many, you know? Also, the solutions area is so narrow. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
A speed of 1,000 solutions. How to sort it out something.
Exactly.
So everything is changing when you jump in more frequency range higher. You know, everything is open up and become more.
Yep, definitely.
Yeah. So then the next one. So this is the explanation, more technical, between two magnets interaction, but it is easy to understand, because the body is the magnet itself, because contain electromagnetic field. So this is the magnet. And interaction between two magnets, you see how two double toruses interact between them, left-right magnet. to double Tauruses, interact on the center, on the green line. The same on the same way our planet interact with the space, electromagnetic field of our planet interact with the electromagnetic field of the sun. Everything is on that shape and on that way. So in the middle of two electromagnetic field toruses, you get the line of interaction. What is actually the dielectric force there? There you open the space. You understand? So you go in ether, in 0 point, what they call vacuum, even vacuum don't exist. But you know, what name you know for that action when you open the space is the free energy source. Actually, when interact two magnets in the middle, on the line of them interaction, you get free energy.
Right.
Infinity right. Source of energy. So that's why when two people interact with them auras, but they're supposed to be in close electromagnetical spectrum vibrational range. For example, you have low range, how we say 500, 700. What's mean the sentence I see you? The sentence I see you is mean that we are both in that platform. So we recognize each other because we are visible for each other. We are close in the frequency range, but it's not that much close, you know?
Right.
For example, I'm 500, you are 700. I see you, you see me, but we are on two edges.
Right.
Or enter, exit, you understand? But yeah, we see each other. But when I say I love you, what is mean that you are 700 and I become 699,
right,
or 689, close to you. So we are getting more match between us and we are able to share data, energy transfer more easy, because I told you water and information ever search for shorter shortcut.
It makes sense.
On that way it goes. So that's why when you fall in love, it's mean that, and when we spoke about the energy coupling, it's mean that this is the vibrational bank so close to you. You have other choices on your level, you know, of all this range, but makes sense to you to have exchange. And you will get more huge amount of free energy during interaction between two strong magnets, not between one weaker, one stronger.
Yes.
They will get a repulsion. So much and stronger dielectric field between them when you have equal or closer to equal magnets, isn't it? So the same with people. When two people, they have equal vibrational state, they are the source of huge amount of free energy between them.
Yes.
Coupling in a way how we spoke before, first to second, second to second, if you remember from the first video. And
yes.
Then when you do this coupling and then they get the free energy like result, they're able to organize this energy for evolving their consciousness. This is like a quantum jump. So one person is able to reach the next level of consciousness alone, but more easy is when you get the opposite magnet to you to catalyze you.
Right.
And then the fields come double. And then the speeds come double, you know?
Speed. Right, which is how the
level.
Yeah, which is how the idea of Kundalini works in relationship. You know,
yes.
If it's respected and equal energy fields come together, then the Kundalini works like that within relationships to help elevate. I mean, you can do it without, you can do it as an individual, but like you said, it magnifies between two, working through the chakras.
Yes, so people have to know that they are magnets. an interaction between two people is the same, like two magnets interact.
Yes.
On the same way. So that is the hidden knowledge in occultism, what they hide. And because of that, they make the arts of coupling so low, you know, no one to guess what they use, because how you see in the fear level, the Taurus is so small. And even interaction between two person in that level, they will give you so less free energy like result, you know?
Yes.
And
to that point, then that's why it's so top. And you hear people say, gosh, I just feel so drained. I was just talking to so-and-so, I feel drained. I was just doing such and such, I feel drained, you know what I mean? And it's just what you've talked about in interaction. You're interacting with a so much lower energy field that they're actually feeding off of you while you're talking or in their space. Or I think people also refer to it here in this country, I'm sure you have a similar terminology, energy vampires. You know, it's just feeding off of other people's energy fields. Eliya, are you there? Like we got maybe a little disconnected from Eliya there. Sure, she'll come back on. I'll just type in here. Yeah, she just dropped off. So she'll be dropping, she'll be coming right back on so we can finish our presentation here. Thank you for joining us as always. And Eliya and I love talking about this. We spend a lot of time just working through, we're working on some other projects and working through these ideas with the idea just to be able to, you know, in a more, not only a conscious way, but a more direct way and in a more a way of illustrating to people the idea of how we can work and interact more easily, and we can come from this base level of love, which is everyone, we're all interested in love. It's a hot topic, but how do we make it more concrete? So I see Eliya, you're back. Yay. So we were just chatting and chatting while you, because I knew that it was one of those things that just froze and popped
off. Just everything was closed in the minute.
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry. Yeah. So that is the point, you know, just the nature of physics is everywhere. It's not right. Only in physics.
Right.
And people are able to analyze the nature and then to get an idea about themselves, yes. And them interaction. So yes. You are a magnet and the tree is the magnet too. So on the same way you interact with tree. And how you get exchange of energy with the tree. And so many people say when you have anxiety or, you know, you're sad, just go and hold the tree.
Right, exactly.
Do you understand? So just you exchange and the electromagnetic field of the tree is so pure, you know, it just feed yes. yours, clean yours.
That makes so much sense.
So on the same way, kids, they are so, they are like a healers from the grandmoms and grandpops, because when they hold them, they feed them with energy. And grandmom ever calmed down the granddaughter because they are, you know, so jumping, full of energy, don't know what to do with it. And the grandmom take little energy, you know, and the kids just calm down. And everyone say, oh, with grandmoms, all the kids, they are so calm. When they come to parents, they freak it out. It's because of that.
That's the first time I've heard it explained like that, Eliya, but that makes so much sense. That
yeah.
is like so
it's
much sense.
Like that,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Everything is give me, take me. It's like this, you know, exchange
yes.
of energy between two sources.
Right.
So that's important. We are source of energy.
Yes.
We produce energy that people are supposed to know.
Right.
So the next one slide.
Already. Ready?
So this is the magnetosphere. See how it's around the the human body. It is around, you know, how you produce indala and around the earth. This is the same principle. So we are the one thing with all the nature and everything, even what we make in the lab, because we follow the natural laws.
Okay.
We are not something different. Okay, so now the next one.
Okay.
And even have a joke, you know, when someone have strong electromagnetic field and people say, he's magnet for people.
Yeah.
Even have this kind of expression, but no one get the idea why, no? So now they know.
Yeah, that makes sense. Exactly. Go ahead.
See? Okay, so this is this is explain how two auras interact to each other, you know? Even it is not need to have physical coupling. In the beginning, you get the electromagnetic coupling. You exchange energy between your auras, between your electromagnetic fields. So
right.
When you feel that other electromagnetic field is so close to you and you like it, like resonance, this other electromagnetic field come close to you. So and get more close interaction. So actually, if you keep someone far away from you, it is interact only with the surface of your aura. And then when you allow this person to come close to you, it means it's come close to your core. It's you, actually, your right. physical body. That's why when you choose your partner, it is so important what you choose, because this person come close to your core, to you.
Yes.
Your body is your core. Your body is your temple. And soul life inside. Body, it's your temple. And
yes.
you're supposed to be aware and respected. This is not, you know, toy. No, this is the temple where your soul life.
Exactly.
Exists in this life. So when you open your aura and someone to come close to your core, it means that you choose precisely this person. No, just by chance. And then make more sense when we spoke about the conscious coupling. It means he goes inside of core. And when you go inside of core, what happened in normal physics? Nuclear reaction, you know?
Right, so, exactly.
So you start to produce new fields of interaction, then you get in space of free energy. Actually, even I ever said, but so less people understood, Kama Sutra in the beginning was made to show how people are source of free energy and how the work between them are source of free energy.
I see.
Itself. And that free energy in occultistic job and ancient people, they used to achieve level of consciousness to achieve other realms, what they call.
Mm-hmm.
So now they make all this knowledge, you know, forbidden, hidden, no one knows, but they use DMT, but they use different kind of drugs, you know, to
right.
push people to reach other realms. You don't need them. You have natural way for these kind of things.
And it, looking at these slides and even this one right here with the two beings and all the colors, and we were just talking about the Kama Sutra and then the various practices like that, it reminds me of, is it the Tibetan monks that practice the rainbow body and ultimately becoming the rainbow body and then just sort of almost dematerializing, they raise their consciousness to the point that they don't die, they just really transition through this rainbow body of all the colors.
Yeah, the Tibetan, they practice this in especially lamas, they choose lamas of this ability. But mm-hmm. also I saw the description of this experiment in an ashram where I've been, of Sri Aurobindo ashram. So Sri Aurobindo and Madam Mira made this kind of experiments.
Yes, I followed yes. Mother Mira for yes. so many years. Just recently yes. she was here. And
yeah, so I passed education in that ashram of Madam Mira.
Wow, yeah, so, that's funny.
So I know all his of the work of inner integral yoga of Sri Aurobindo and
mother, oh, yeah,
in all her subscription, especially in the book Ajanta. So she described all the exercises, how she tried to make less density human body, you know?
Yeah, you know, and it's, at some point I'll do a PowerPoint. I had years ago gotten her book where she did the art, where she brought down so much of the knowledge of the auric fields and how we come together, how we interact. And it was a book of it, which probably is not in print any longer, but it's a beautiful representation of all that we are showing today.
Yes.
Did you remember? Do you remember that book? The book that she did, where it was all of her paintings, and it was the representation of all these art.
There are several books. There are several books. What she has, and also
with one specific one was just her paintings. She did a lot of writing of books, but she did a book was just a picture book of just her paintings. I was only aware of one. You're saying that she has more books that were just her paintings in them.
Yeah, she has.
Oh, okay. I didn't see.
I have to bring you with me in Pondicherry and Auroville, and then you will be surprised. I love
You're
this
gonna
place.
Go to Pondicherry because yes. I've studied her for 30 something or more years. I mean, because yes. and Andrew Harvey's work, I love his work. And then for a while, I mean, he obviously she was his mother for years. And you could see in his work, he just has so much, even in his current work. I just got his book in the mail, his latest one called Heart Yoga, but he has so much of the mother and the female balance, female energy in his work. He does really good stuff, Andrew Harvey.
The Mother Mira and Sri Aurobindo Yoga, they call integral yoga. And this includes everything.
Yes.
Not only exercises, this is the way of understanding of universe.
Yeah.
And of the existence of the earth. This is so famous book. I have most of them. I will show
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I do too. I have a lot. I have most of her work as well. But being an artist, you know, back then, 30 years ago, when I was following her and I was going to ashrams, I'd never been to Pondicherry. But when she came to the States, you know, I would go. But what was interesting is that I read so many of the books, but when she came out with the book of nothing but her artwork, it really spoke to me, being an artist, and so much of what comes through to me in my art about the stuff we're talking about, and you've seen some of my work, it comes through like that. And so to see Mother Mira do this book of nothing but pictures of beings and spirits and colors mixing, and this is this and this is that, it really helped inform me as an artist that really shared a lot of the spiritual information that was coming through me to continue to work like that. And that's why I love that particular one.
But yeah, and also they have so famous speakers. They are my friends. I'm able to invite them. And especially Shradalu, he's quantum physics, graduated in ashram school mm-hmm. and then in UK, and he has a famous lecture on the subject, who am I, to explain what is the really purpose of existence.
Wow.
And other of my teachers, what I have in ashram, they are really good speakers. I mean,
well, we'll have to definitely bring them down and have you invite them. That'll
yeah.
be good.
So, even one of them that they have a birthday. Wish you happy birthday, sir.
Oh, so, we'll say happy
yes,
birthday. Yeah.
I will send him this video after we finish.
Yeah, that'll be good. So yeah. I know we have a few more to finish up, and I think we're coming up more on like an hour and a half, and I know we try to cut it off around this time so we just don't overload. Yeah. You try to give it in doses. So go ahead and I'll want me to go to the next slide?
Yes, next slide.
Okay. I know I was the one that sidetracked us here, but it just had me, Mother Mirror and the Tibetan, it just came up, so I had to.
She's so cool lady.
Smart. Yeah. Let me see. I'm hitting the wrong one. Oh, Robyn, you're tired. I'm hitting the one on the screen share, thinking, how come it's not moving? Go ahead now. I'm sorry.
Yeah. So this is the pictures of one scientific person, Benjamin, what made them 19th centuries. This is the geometry of consciousness. So after so many years, he analyzed the consciousness of people and tried to make them in geometric view. And he discovered actually that the geometry of consciousness is related to geometry of aura of the beings. So interaction between the consciousness and aura, even in geometrical shape, they are so close related. And when you or someone manage to reshape your aura, is directly influence your consciousness.
Gotcha.
Directly, and level of your consciousness. So on that way, people is able to understand how through them consciousness, they are able to reshape them aura, I mean to heal them aura if they have some kind of influence in them field, but actually directly resulting in internal organs and diseases. And how we know we have so famous, sudden cures of cancers or some kind of dramatic diseases in people where they only work with their consciousness to themselves. I mean, they change their belief system and they, I mean, force their will and conscience to heal themselves and to change the structure of their body.
Right. That makes sense. Yeah. And here, just for people who want to know that, Dr. Eliya wrote on the sidebar there in the chat group, the Benjamin Betts 19th century geometrical, psychological, mathematical illustrations of consciousness. So you can look that up and get more information on that. This is the first time I had seen this myself when you shared it with me earlier. So
And also that's why people say with who you interact, the same you become, because other electromagnetic field reshape yours.
This is so funny. So does this go back to why, you know, people who are very close to their dogs, and dogs are so loving, they already are at the, they always are, their aura is already at the love frequency anyway. And they connect to us so much that people and their dogs start looking alike, you know how?
Yes. And even they get your habits, even they don't understand you, because your electromagnetic field interact with them and you reshape each other.
And that also happens with people who are married for so many years. They really begin to take on each other's sort of looks, even if they look very much different. It's amazing how,
Or adopted children on the same way.
That's true with adoptive children. You're right. You do see how, especially if they're adopted as babies, they really seem to almost look exactly like their adoptive parents.
Yeah. So that is the connection. The shape of aura is directly connected with the consciousness.
I love that.
So that's why we have to keep clean our electromagnetic field, our aura. We have to have energy hygiene, you know?
So it goes back to just being very protective of everything that's connected to our body, our auric fields, our electric magnetic fields. You know, it goes, you know, when you go back, I remember when I was coming up, I was raised in the church, you know, because my grandfather was a minister. And I mean, we went every day of the week. And I swore to myself, when I became an adult, I wasn't going to go to church again. I'm so tired of it. And some of it was so archaic too, you know, the whole idea, you can't do this, you can't do that, with relationships. And then, you know, we come along with the free love of the 60s. And so by the time, you know, we were coming into our female and our being young women, you know, it was more modern to, oh, you know, we could be with the person, you know, not to be married. And I don't agree with having to be married to be in a committed relationship either. But the point of so much of it about being committed and making sure you know who you're coming together with and being equally yoked and all those things is part of ancient knowledge that sort of got corrupted and sort of we kind of turned against it because it just seemed like ugh. But it makes so much sense in the larger scheme of the knowledge that it, that we're bringing back and that so many others are bringing back into consciousness about being protective of all of these energetic fields. Because in fact, so much damage occurs when we're not protective and we don't understand how they interact.
Yes, and when you interact with something what is not necessary for you, just because it's fashion, or, you know, it is like society brings that you're supposed to do, but it is still your electromagnetic field is not mature to do
right. To do it, exactly. You're right. That's crazy.
You understand? Is it the same like they got married in the 2-3 ages in some Muslim countries with the 40 years old male?
Yeah, exactly.
So what exactly they do, they don't know. I mean,
exactly. That makes sense.
Yes. Well, so next one.
I think this might be the last one, isn't it?
Yes.
Oh, no, we got it. Another one after that.
Go down, down, down.
I have to get on the right thing. See, I keep on hitting the wrong one.
Okay, yes. You just like the on the play button, that's it.
No, it's like...
play button. So this is a different type of auras when you get different interactions between or... two auras, or when you have different kind of feelings in you. So how we say the consciousness change the shape of aura and see how many different types you are able to get, good or bad. So that's why when you feel like some kind of lower feeling, fears, anxiety, depression, whatsoever, just try to arise your consciousness. Then the shape of aura will reconstruct itself because you are like energy device. You produce free energy what rebuild the layers of your aura. Mm-hmm. That people, it is supposed to know. If you are not able to do yourself, if you feel that you will is not enough to do it, then you need a kind of therapist to do for you. But you are able through your will to do. Just you have to train your will to move, to be on focus and to represent your conscious level. Mm-hmm. It's like you feel your aura with love or joy or happiness on a place of fear, sadness, depression.
Yeah, and it goes back to that whole idea of Om, you know, being that universal sound that just really calms you. Even, you know, when you can just be frantic, but you just stop and just internally just say Om or anything. I mean, you know, that's the universal, but anything that calms you, you know, you can just say love or peace over and over, or joy over and over, because those words have the frequencies that it just starts really calming you down and bring you down. And it goes back to, you know, meditating is not so much always closing your eyes and sitting still for hours on end. Those are meditations in themselves, just focusing down and repeating a word that carries the frequency that you're trying to bring your aura and your conscious state back in to alignment with.
Yes, and also just to know, chanting of Om is a representation of several seed sounds what come from first chakra and ending to seven. That's why it is a harmonizing of all the chakras, because contain all the seed sound. It is when we say Om, this is the sum. But when you're chanting, you're supposed to produce all the seed sound and finally become like, it is like common sound Om. But actually, it's not Om. It is like seed sound through the seventh chakra.
Yeah.
That is chanting of Om. And also Hyalpu is the organ chanting, because all the organs, they have a sound. And when you chant the sound, you just energize and calm down this organ. It is like for liver, it's shh. So that's why when you start to say to your kids something, do this kind of thing, you say shh, don't do this, shh, don't do this, you know? They understand, but people don't understand what they do. This is because this is the sound, chanting sound of liver. And that liver, this is the energy of wind, and all the kids, they are under the energy of wind from their birth up to 12. Wind rules them up to 12. So everything is wind with them, hyperactivity, speaking, all the things what they do wrong in home and this and that, you know, it's because of wind. So wind, it's liver. And when you say shh, so they calm down. So even when you listen the leaves, what they do? Shh.
Yeah.
Wind in leaves. It's the same sound.
Which is also why, you know, in the current medical fields of allopathy, where medicine and drugs are being used to control and manipulate people's electromagnetic fields such that you can't function as the human being that you were designed to function as, you know, in children, the whole new labeling of things, ADHD, you know, hyperactive. I mean, you know, this is a made up phenomenon that, they get you to buy into, and then that is, you know, artificially controlling, and taking the children further away from their natural abilities to control themselves through learning and learned behavior, like you said, that's being instructed by the parent. But when you give up those first 12 years of instructing your child yourself through your own energetic field over to the drug Ritalin and other drugs to control them, now you're creating that artificial relationship that then these kids come off and they're lost and they're on drugs and they're on psychotics and antidepressants and stuff like that, because they don't know how to operate. I mean, here just more of that, just pointing out again the artificial ways that society are looking to control us.
Yeah, everything is twisted to surf.
Everything.
Mm-hmm. So the next one is last, I think.
Yep. Oh, here, I'm doing it again. I'm sorry. It's like you'd think by the 12th slide, 18th slide, I'd have it together. But yeah, I'm just looking at that same. Yeah, I'm on the monitor with everyone else.
Okay.
Go ahead.
So this is the exactly what Carl Jung said between for in interaction of two beings. The meeting of two personalities is like the contact of two chemical substances. If there is any reaction, both are transformed.
Wow. Yes. That's huge. That's exactly what happens.
So during your transformation, actually, you become a creator, because when you transform, you release something from you. Understand? But when both bodies, I mean, like electromagnetical field starts to transform, they create what we call new being. But this new being come from this free energy source, what appears between them interaction.
Yeah, that's good. That is really good. I mean, that was like, oh my goodness. You know, just being able, you know, visually for us to begin to hone in now, we've been talking about love and relationship things and with Claire birth, and that was just a beautiful time, you know, listening to her talk, and we'll have to have her on again. You know, but now let's, as we're moving this along, to really begin to understand the energy, just how this energy is working. What does this look like? What is ancient wisdom, ancient knowledge talking about with these things? And how do we relate this to our current times? So this is huge. This is good.
Yeah, it is a really easy thing when you just change point of view. Yep. And to not look, I mean, not look life like you watch the old movie in old screen. Just, you know, put a subtitles, understandable for your belief system, and to represent original style stuff, but with subtitles, you know? To
yeah, be exactly.
Understandable.
You need the subtitles because you can look at these things in time and you're like, okay, you know. But yeah. in a good, sensible, down-to-earth way. And I think that's how you and I relate. And that's what this show is about. Let's just keep it good, sensible, down-to-earth, but with science or with technology, understanding or ancient wisdom, especially to understand better in our more current times, the significance. And how do we get, and I think just even with this slideshow today, it helps people understand how to get back. You know, just some simple things you see. You know, how to get back, how to reconnect with your aura, how to expand it, how to understand what's happening energetically. You know, when you come in contact with, you know, after looking at this video, when people come in contact with someone today, tomorrow, the next day, and they start feeling these ways, they're like, oh, I remember Dr. Eliya, they were talking about, okay, so let me just meditate for a moment, or let me just, you know, think love, you know, and expand my field, and let me move away from this person because I'm feeling that energy is being pulled out of me, and I don't want that. I want to control more now, more so exactly how I'm in interaction with the world around me. So why don't you take us out, Dr. Eliya, let's, you know, wrap everything up and then we'll close out and be back next
time. Yeah, and start to try, you know, have one famous exercise for ninjas. It's just, I love this exercise. And then you start to feel how your energy works. You just light the candle and try it with your hand, just, you know, just like when you put, suddenly you head around the candle, just so how it is in English, just to take out the fire.
Okay, just not using your hand, but using your mind?
Yeah, using your mind, you just light the candle and do just like that with your hand.
Okay, almost
your
like
energy flows the fire.
I got
you. Do you understand? This is the famous exercise, how to you are able to feel your energy and to manage your energy for ninjas.
So we're talking about lighting the candle and then putting your hand up to it. Don't use
the wind. No, it's not wind. This is your energy. You
know? That's your energy.
Like
yeah, I'm just making it clear.
And then you start to feel that your hand emit energy.
Right.
And other famous exercises and to put in box little small things, different things. And you start to look this box. It's like several minutes. You see, you have, for example, one ball, small ball, and one triangle, one square, different small things, you know. You remember them shape first. And then you close. And open like after half an hour, and you remember shape and color, and then you close, and then you open, and with your closed eyes, you start to feel the color. You understand? Mm-hmm. So when you pick up, and you say, I pick up, for example, the red pearl, for example, or ball. And when you start to feel the color, exactly feel the color, because all the color is a resonance level and meet the frequency. Mm-hmm. So you tune your hand, you tune your electromagnetic spectrum to the spectrum of the red color, and it's match, and you feel.
Yes.
This is the simple tricks what you're able to practice. And then you start to, and you're able to practice with people. For example, can I feel the hand of this person? Can I feel the kiss of this person? Can I feel the touch? Can I feel, you know, to interact? But
you know,
with small things you're supposed to start. And you know why? To believe to yourself.
Yeah. And this is so interesting. You saying this reminds me of a recurring dream that I used to have when I was a little girl. And I'm always been a lucid dreamer. So most of my dreams are always very lucid. So even as a kid, I lived in a studio, almost like an artist studio, you would think, loft in Paris. It was like a room like that, because it was upstairs is where I slept, but then downstairs where all my artwork was. And in this dream, I always would go to the wall and my eyes would be closed. And there were these big square paintings on the wall that were just a single color. So it'd be just orange, just red, just blue. And I would stand there, and not only would I feel the color, I would then see the color in my mind, but it also would activate senses on my tongue. So if it was orange, it would activate and it would create the taste of oranges in my mouth. If it was yellow, it would hit the outside part of my tongue.
Mm-hmm.
And it would taste like lemons. And I would always have this dream. And as I got older, I realized that as an artist that focuses on color and texture, it was almost like me training in my lucid dream state to recognize color and the expression of color and how it interfaces with our bodies and our senses. So it was like so funny, because you were saying that dream came back to me. Those dreams came back to me, and it was all the time, you know, it was just these almost a repeat of me learning all these different colors and textures. So that reminds me of that.
Yeah, because the color is more close to the solid matter, like a frequency range.
Yeah.
Because we spoke before, this is own, this is what we call God. Then the energy compressed to the consciousness, this energy compressed to the thoughts, then compressed to the sound, to the light, color, and reappear.
Yes,
and then reappear. Matter. Yeah. Finally we appear. So in a sense, so it's more close to us to recognize the next more high frequency range of electromagnetic spectrum, color. Then we are able to feel the sound, then we are able to feel the light, you know, with our senses.
Right.
So but it's related in our vibrational state. That's why we speak about at least to reach love level, you know?
Right.
Because this is working platform for our existence, for our senses, and also we open additional senses in us, not only this five what we have.
So in the example of that recurring lucid dream that I was just describing, I was dealing with matter, color, and taste. So would taste be on the same vibration as sound, as you talk about going from matter to color to sound to light?
Would taste be together?
Okay.
Everything have color, have sound, have light, have thought, have conscious, have part in allness.
Right. So that I'm specifically speaking of taste, because in this dream, taste was being elucidated. So would taste be on the same spectrum as sound?
And also of color, because you have sensor organs, is papilla in your tongue, and they are specific papilla for each test. But each test is the amorphic field, is plasma itself, is fields.
Okay.
Gotcha. You understand? So before color is light, and before light is sound. So lemon can exist like color, can exist like light, sound, or so on, to the source.
Right. Okay.
Just a different vibrational state. It's the same like you. Robyn exists here on the solid matter. Robyn exists in color, a range of electromagnetic spectrum, light range, sound, thought, consciousness. In owners, Robyn have IP.
Yeah.
This is Robyn in different frequency range.
It's range, you. Exactly. I see what you're saying.
So even that they say that we exist in many places, not only in one, it's true because we exist in different vibrational ranges.
Right. I love that. I love those analogies when we think about how, and then when you realize this whole way that we move into matter, then you realize how to create matter. You know, energetically, you realize that the manifestation that we have as humans come out of this whole vibrational development into matter. So, all righty, well, we're going to go ahead and start closing it out because Eliya and I, we will continue to talk and you guys will be here with us for 3 hours, 4 hours, because oftentimes when you and I talk, we just talk and then we got to go, but then we get on chat, on WeChat, it just can go on. And we are on two different time zones. So half the day you're asleep or half the day I'm asleep for you, and we still get all of this talking done. It's crazy. So once again, we just want to thank our audience for joining us and being a part of Ask Dr. Eliya and Robyn show. And being a part of what we're doing, we really appreciate when you guys like our Facebook and the shows, and you give your input, and you're asking questions or you're sharing experiences. We encourage you to continue to do that because it really helps us to form these shows so that because we really want to be on the pulse point of all of our development. We don't want to just come here like talking heads, boop, 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 telling you stuff. We really are looking to be on the pulse point of the kind of information that our group of people are looking for, seeking, because we're all growing and we're all developing together here. And oftentimes you guys say things that spark with us and we think, oh yeah, you and I'll start talking about Eliya and it forms a show. So once again, thank you for joining us today and hanging in here with us on Ask Dr. Eliya and Robyn. And we'll look forward to being back with you next week. And we'll continue on this PowerPoint series as we talk about the morphogenic field. So thank you, Eliya.
Thank you so much to be with us. And see you next week.
All righty. Bye-bye. Take care, guys. Bye.